She seems a little. Oh! Hirata!
Right there!
Oh, the big right hand!
Hirata! Firing rights! Hammering Heqin! 14 seconds!
Lin Heqin's gotta move!
With bout number two, Heqin with an early inside leg kick to set the tone.
Now I'm expecting Lin Heqin to really utilize that lead leg like she showed me earlier this week. She's got a nice little push kick, but she has to utilize that jab. She has to punish Itsuki every single time Itsuki tries to enter the pocket.
Heqin working that front leg early on. The first of 3 5-minute rounds in this women's MMA matchup.
She's staying busy with that jab with the rangefinder there, and you saw her step in for the first time with that jab to try to touch Itsuki.
Nice. Straight right from Heqin. That'll wake you up early in the morning.
Yeah, outside leg coming out firing right now.
I'm surprised Azuki's kind of standing in range right there. She's, you know, she's in that range where Lin Heqin can touch her, and so she needs to either get out or decide to get in, make or break that distance.
Mixing it up nicely, some early combinations from Lin Heqin. Again, the main card, less than 90 minutes from now on Prime Video.
At this point, Itsuki doesn't seem to be fazed by anything. She's real relaxed. She's not surprised by Lin Heqin's speed. Able to evade the kick right there. So this is still just a feeling out process, Brent.
Another straight right, glanced off the left shoulder of Itsuki Hirata.
I like Lin Heqin's center channel weapon. She comes right down the middle with really quick hand speed, and she's mixing in leg kicks really well. Look at the damage that's starting to build up on the lead leg of Itsuki. Yeah, Itsuki needs to change things up right now.
Yeah, you can see it right there on the back of that left hamstring, and she's just standing right there in the pocket in the range where Lin Heqin can touch her.
What's the mindset of Hirata so far? Hasn't done a lot.
I think she's just looking for an opening.
There it is, the
just like that. She gets that single leg, but look, Lin Heqin defends with a front headlock, able to pop right back up to her feet. That's going to build her confidence in this situation right now. Itsuki needs to keep threatening that, but I want to see you be a little bit more active with the hands. Utilize her jab. You know, start mixing in her leg kicks, because right now, she's getting teed off on.
Yeah, if Itsuki starts pursuing the takedown like she normally does, she wasn't phased in the Ranzwan fight when Jihin was able to just continually defend the takedown. Like, Itsuki stuck with the game plan. She was eventually able to get her down. She came up on the short end of that match, but nonetheless, she never lost confidence or got frustrated.
Four straight jabs from Heqin, testing that distance, and then packs Hirata off as she went in.
That was nice timing on that overhand right. I think she's starting to figure things out a little bit on the speed of Lin Heqin, because Lin Heqin is looking remarkably fast right now. See, look at that. Again, she slipped out of the way, came over with that right hand. She's been working hard on her boxing, has Itsuki Hirata.
2 minutes left in round one. 3 5-minute rounds, and again, the fight judged as a whole, as opposed to round by round.
See, that's a nice weapon, because what it does is it also sets up the single leg takedown, so she can throw that overhand right and go right to the lead leg, get in nice and tight. And I'd like to see Itsuki maybe threaten a little bit more with the level changes, start just feinting things at her.
Absolutely. I think Azuki's done a good job of studying film here, because Lin Heqin has that fast jab. She also has that nice leg kick, but you can see the chin of Lin Heqin right there where it's reddened. And so there's some little bit of superficial damage, if nothing else, at this point in time. And Hirata is really timing that overhand right well.
Yeah, she's got to start moving away from those leg kicks. She's not checking anything, but she does have at least the sense to back up, but she needs to come right back. She needs to close that distance and really get active with her boxing right now. See, she's trying to time that overhand right, but it seems like that's the only weapon she really seems comfortable in throwing.
Well, the problem with the overhand right now, Mitch, is that Lin Heqin, she's a little bit taller, but she also has these really long arms, so she can stay very rangy and out of the pocket as well.
What I also like about Lin Heqin, Brent, is her head movement, right? She's always a little bit off center, right? Look at this, she digs one overhook right there, and now she's gotta start pushing on that head. You can see Itsuki's got that body locked, but she digs the underhook on her right side, and she needs to keep Itsuki Hirata upright, as upright as she can, so that Itsuki Hirata doesn't drop down and start attacking those legs.
Couple of knees here from Hirata. Up against the fence is Lin Heqin. First real attack from Hirata so far. You see, you guys mentioned earlier that left leg, the back of the leg of Hirata has taken damage early on in this fight.
I know Rich called this a crossroad matchup for both these ladies, but this is a crossroads position right here. As we end the situation, oh, look at that face planted her just like that. That was beautiful. But Lin Heqin popped right back up.
At the end of round one, the bell in round two of three in this catchweight battle, women's MMA, second bout of this lead card. One on Prime Video One, Marias versus Johnson Two.
Good movement right now from Itsuki. She looks very calm, very collected. Lin Heqin needs to press a little bit more. She needs to get in and get out, utilize some angles, not just stand there directly in front of her. If she starts to get on her bicycle a little bit and start creating these angles, it's going to be harder for Itsuki Hirata to back her up against the wall, and that's typically where she likes to get the clinch and then look for the takedowns.
Yeah, you saw that level change from Itsuki Hirata right there, and when she's doing that, she's at least keeping Lin Heqin guessing so that Lin Heqin can't tee off with that jab or start throwing that leg kick. It backs her up. But when she's standing in the pocket like that, Lin Heqin can just tee off.
I know the corner was very confident about the success that Hirata had in that first 5 minutes, but right now, all these little touches, all these little shots that Lin Heqin's able to score are all adding up in the judges' eyes. Itsuki Hirata needs to start controlling this matchup if she wants to walk away a winner.
Absolutely, I'm not sure I would have Itsuki Hirata ahead on the scorecards at the end of the 5 minutes just based on the first round performance.
Again, it's judged as a whole, the entire three rounds, 5 minutes each.
See, look, Lin Heqin, even though she's, you know, on her back foot and she's moving, she's creating these angles. She's moving, she's not stationary, and that makes her a lot harder to take down.
Couple of inside leg kicks from Heqin, working that jab pretty well as well, measuring that distance with Hirata. 2 minutes into this second round.
And what she's done is she's changed her footwork in this round. Now she's moving to Hirata's weak side, right? So she's not gonna get pressed up against the wall, right? She keeps circling away to her left side. Charges her off and gets right back to her game.
Rich, it's gotta get frustrating for Hirata. Every time she goes in, Lin Heqin so slippery to get out of there.
Yeah, it's very difficult, but Hirata's letting her dictate the pace. See, typically when a fighter comes out, they will take the center of the ring, and you can see Lin Heqin is in the center of the ring right now, but she rarely lets herself get backed up outside of that circle, so she knows she has ample space to turn and not get trapped in the corner, so to speak.
Midpoint of round two, midpoint of the fight.
See, look at the activity from Lin Heqin. She's always putting something in the face of Hirata, whether it's a jab, whether it's a leg kick. She's always mixing things in. That's like the first strike that Hirata's even thrown, and it didn't quite connect.
She didn't step forward on that strike. I'm beginning to wonder if she's having trouble moving with that leg now.
You see that left leg, not just in the back of the leg, but all over on the thigh, red marks for Hirata. She's taking some damage.
Yeah, not only is Lin Heqin controlling the striking aspect of this match, but she's also doing damage, and that's a higher category. Itsuki Hirata needs to pick things up. There you go, she needs to get in tight. But see how Lin Heqin keeps circling away from Itsuki Hirata's right side? That's gonna be more difficult for Hirata to get in tight or even throw that right hand that she was throwing in the first five.
Yeah, this has been a game of footwork for Lin Heqin. She's managed the range of this fight about 90% of the time, keeping Itsuki Hirata exactly where she wants her.
Beautiful mixture of the jab from Heqin and the low leg kicks. 120 in round two.
See, but see how she's feinting? She's trying to keep Hirata guessing by mixing in the feints, throwing these little twitches so that Hirata doesn't really know where things are coming from.
Going nice. For the double is Hirata. Itsuki, can she slide away this time? Shoves Hirata into the fence.
That was a good job by Hirata to go from the sprawl of Lin Heqin right into the body lock. And this is where Itsuki Hirata really excels inside her clinch game, is when she's tight, pressing you up against the wall.
She loves utilizing that knee to the inside of the right thigh of Heqin. And now to the outside of the left thigh.
See, this is where Hirata needs to change things up. She needs to reap for the trip. She needs to redirect, try to off-balance her, not just try to pull her to that same side, right? Watch, Lin Heqin's gonna try to pop out that right side, but Itsuki Hirata gets it done, and here it is with a scarf hold position. She's gonna try to neutralize the arm, but Lin Heqin pops right back up.
Yeah, you know, Lin Heqin went to that the side that she had the underhook on, but here's Hirata coming with the Kimura, the standing Kimura.
14 seconds in round two. Heqin riding the back of Itsuki Hirata. And now they go to the deck once again.
Using the Kimura to end up on top and end the first 10 minutes in a very dominant position. She could have been saved by the bell right to the leg. He got to give the edge to Lin Heqin. If Itsuki Hirata can get into that clinch position a little bit quicker in this 5 minutes right here, she might be able to get a submission, because once she grabs onto something, she got that Kimura, she was not letting it go. She tried to take that arm back to Tokyo with her. So she needs to be a little bit more aggressive and urgent when it comes to that takedown.
Yeah, you know, with less than 5 minutes of action left, Hirata's got a lot of work cut out for her here, because if that submission at the end of round two was not scored as a near finish, which I don't believe that it necessarily would have been, then I'm not sure even a near finish in round three is enough to overcompensate for all the damage that you see on that leg at this point in time.
Heqin, though, most likely got saved by the bell instead of getting submitted at the end of round two. Straight right, comes back to the left. Nice combinations here from Heqin.
Yeah, that's what Lin Heqin needs to do. She needs to keep those hands in the face, but I like the feint coming from Itsuki Hirata, but Lin Heqin is moving well, but now she's stationary. If Itsuki Hirata can start to press forward and look for a takedown, she could end up in a very similar position that she ended that 10 minutes at.
Yeah, Itsuki needs to look for that takedown, but you know, she's got to do something on her feet, because at this point in time, Lin Heqin is just throwing completely relaxed, and Itsuki Hirata is not throwing a single strike that Lin Heqin has had to respect.
Every time Hirata goes for that double leg takedown, you've talked about Heqin with the beautiful sprawl to get right back up.
Yeah, beautiful sprawl, but this is where Itsuki wanted to get. So all she does really is use that double leg to close the distance. Once she gets that clinch, her hands are locked. She's sneaking around right now to the back. It'd be important for Lin Heqin to keep her back against the fence so Itsuki Hirata cannot really sneak around that backside. That's exactly what she did right there. Now her back's fully against the fence, and Itsuki cannot sneak around to the back.
Yeah, she was able to turn in and get that underhook, and that's what allowed her to swing back around.
Look at that nice little drop down to the single leg. Let's see if she can complete it. Reaps the leg, gets her down. It's important for Lin Heqin to work her way back up, and she does just that, but Itsuki starts to make her pay on the way up.
Yeah, eating some leather on the way up as Lin Heqin now takes a knee to the face. Heqin trying to work the body.
I thought for a moment that Itsuki was going to drop to the arm and guillotine.
Good job by Lin Heqin to turn Itsuki around and press her up against the wall now. Might be a good idea to disengage, but it looks like this front headlock position is keeping her pressed into this position.
Final 2 minutes of the fight. Hirata and Lin.
Good damage to the legs right there with the knees.
I'll tell you what, I'm looking at Hirata's leg right here in front of me on the cage, and man, she's gonna have trouble walking this week.
Brutal damage to that left leg, but she is fighting hard. They're back up against the fence.
Itsuki, it looks like she's trying to time one of these legs so she can possibly trip or throw across, just there like that. That was beautiful.
Takedown for Lin Heqin.
If Itsuki can wrap it up here in these last 90 seconds, it would be a thing of beauty for Itsuki Hirata. Let's see if she can pass over. She likes this position. She floats over the top, but Lin Heqin ends up in the front headlock position.
Now Heqin looking to fire a right hook as Hirata comes off the canvas, and they go toe-to-toe once again in the one circle with 107 remaining.
What a great scramble. Lin Heqin was in the furnace right there. That was Itsuki Hirata's primary best position that she could possibly be in, and with a minute left, I'm pretty sure she's probably secured the victory at this point in time.
You can't count Itsuki Hirata up. All she needs is one more takedown, but she needs to press for it right there, just like that. She gets in tight, but Lin Heqin's doing a good job of framing off the face and keeping that distance.
Beautiful defense by Lin Heqin. 40 seconds to go. Backs her off with a jab to Heqin. Hirata will have to get aggressive inside the final 30 seconds here.
Hirata's got to go. There should be a sense of urgency. 30 seconds left.
Yeah, she had about a minute left, and she could have put the pedal down, but she seems a little... Oh,
Hirata!
Right there!
The big right hand!
Hirata firing rights, hammering Heqin. 14 seconds!
Lin
Her might stop this. She's got 10 seconds.
Down to eight. Heqin survives it for the moment. Can she survive four more seconds?
Saved by the bell twice. Saved by the bell twice.
Lin Heqin survives the bell to end round three as Hirata.
Was that enough to earn the victory, Mitch?
I don't know, man. That was it.
It's okay.